Do you find medium hatchbacks so boring that you'd take a 500-pound hit for a less practical but similarly sized body style? Well, look no further. This, the sleek four-door Hyundai i30 Fastback. It's the fourth and final pillar of the i30 family, sitting alongside the hatch, tour estate and of course the wild i30 and hot hatch. Just don't call it a coupe, despite what the Korean firm says. There'll be no three-door renaissance. Fastback doesn't have a huge number of main rivals, but cars like the Skoda Octavia hatch, Mazda 3 Fastback and even the much more premium, and expensive, Mercedes CLA are of a similar ilk. But this isn't a car that you'll see a lot of. Hyundai is predicting sales of just 600 units a year, which means it'll be outsold by its more conventional hatchback sibling by a considerable margin. Sorry to be the bearer of bad news, but this is simply a reskinned i30 hatch with a 25mm lower roofline, suspension dropped by another 5mm, a slightly smaller grille and a redesigned front bumper incorporating new LED daytime running lights. In fact, if you were expecting accelerative excitement, go elsewhere. The engine options here are all petrol, for now. A new 1.6 diesel is coming later in 2018. But none of the drivetrains can pull the Fastback through 0 to 62 miles per hour in under 9 seconds. Actually, despite its lackluster on paper stats, it's not a bad steer at all, in particular with the 118 bhp 1.0T GDI. The lower drive height and relatively lightweight engine over the nose work together to dramatically improve turn-in, while the extra 115mm of length over the back axle means the rear moves around more than in the hatch, which makes it feel more playful. This isn't to say it's engaging in the way the current Focus or Astra is. The feel through the rim of the steering wheel isn't anywhere near as forensic, but still the recipe works. Going back to the engine for a second, we found the 1.0-liter the pick of the range. Its 118 bhp is delivered in a linear fashion and there's always twist on tap should you need it. The manual box is fine too, though nothing particularly inspiring to write home about. We also sampled the 138 bhp 1.4 turbo petrol bolted to a twin clutch auto and found this a far less inspiring proposition. The extra weight of the additional cylinder and the extra parts in the box means it feels far, far heavier and hence less eager to change direction in quite the same agile fashion. Ride quality is well judged, with the 17-inch wheels on our car matched impressively to the damping. You get 18s on the 1.4, and they make things a little spikier.